I push to their top. This is how you use cloak.
Right.
Oh, one more!
Yeah, sniper is on the right side.
Okay, hello guys. I'm showing you now how to cloak. And I'm first showing you some perfect examples, like this one. So what you can see here, I went behind them and then shooted them, not straight in. And as you can see now, they are almost all dead. I'll continue the flanking, not just camp and cap the point. And now when they spawn, we spawn kill them all. With the cloak on, of course, so you get more points and they cannot see you when they are running straight. And now you can continue on the same place, but probably you will die, so it's now better to leave or change the spot, like I do here. But now I realize there's too much coming and I don't have cloak, so it's better to back up. And the next clip is actually the same thing, but now on Metro. So you need to find a good spot and get behind them, and now I get scanned, so I need to start shooting. And I was lucky there was no sniper behind me. And still people say that cloak is for noobs and it doesn't help the team. And now here I kept the point alone, basically. And this is, I think, the perfect one.
I killed the noob.
So as you can see, after I find a good spot, I start cloaking. And then we need to clear the way to allow our teammates to come to the point. And now they are free to come, but they are still camping, they are noobs.
He's on the left.
And now, there's a device that went smoothly. And as you can see, now I got blitzed, and I will cloak. Because if there's someone behind, there's a chance he doesn't kill me before I get up. And now I get melee'd, fuck. This is also a perfect example how you can cap the point alone. So the round has started, there's 6 enemies on the point, they capped it. No one's doing anything. So now I need to get to a good spot before I start killing, and it's here. And now you need to be fast as possible before they realize. And boom, you cleared the whole point. Alone. And now hopefully the noobs will come and cap the point for you. And next we speak about flanking behind. So instead of going straight in, we try to get behind them, and now I get scanned, I need to shoot them fast. And like this. So instead of going straight in, we need to get behind them some way. So flanking behind. Now I can see there's a bubble, and they're also pushing here. I will go help my teammates. And they're done. And the heat, of course, you can kill it right away. And now, you will get behind and kill them all with the cloak. But you need to be sneaky and really quiet when you do that. And this is one of my favorites on Peshawar. I do it all the time. I get scanned several times, then I know they're out of scan. And I get behind them. And then you can get the right side and start capping there easily. So nukes, this is one of the hardest maps to cloak, but it helps the team most if you're good. On the right side, if there's no recons, you can easily try and push there with the cloak. And then you need to cap the left room. Like this, and then help your teammates from behind, so they can advance. And now your job is to hold the left room while they get into that point, and also to the middle. So this clip, this is what I call distraction. So as you can see, there's a lot of going on the right side, smoke and a lot of shooting, and also our heat, so enemies focusing on the heat, they're like, oh fuck, there's heat. So now it's my chance to go behind them and not shoot here, wait until a good spot and shoot. And now I killed 4 and there's also more dead, so you can push and hope there's no one. You can sense it and cut the right side of Pesha. And this is what I call get to a good spot before shooting. So here I can see I'm not gonna shoot the first guy. There's a second guy behind him, I shoot them, and unfortunately there's a third guy.
Oh come on!
This time. This is really good example. So we could shoot this guy now, but we first get to a safe place. Let's shoot it now.
Blitz.
I know Peshawar. By the way, it's really good map for cloaking. So escape the blitz, help your teammate. And now, as you can see, there's a guy on the point, but we don't want to kill him straight away. We get to the right spot before shooting. Here we can kill the both campers. Now kill the guy, somebody kills him before me. And then cap the right side and just hold it. It's really important to Peshawar. And same thing on Metro. So Kamidi is going and killing everybody. Now he died. So before shooting now, I'll make sure my back is safe and I'm in the good spot. And now they are fucking confused because I shoot them from behind. And now we just hold this side. Like this. And still the same thing. I need to show it so many times because this is the most important thing on cloaking, I think. So I cloaked the point just to make sure they don't shoot me. And he scanned me just after that, so I was lucky. Now there's so many guys on the point from our team, so I can try and suicide or then do a perfect cloak like this. So I get in a perfect spot and shoot them from behind and they're fucking confused. Yes. And Attica is really hard map for cloaking, but we try to do the same thing here. We sneak and now try to kill them all. Unfortunately, it's fucking NA, and the enemy doesn't die. And I die, but you saw the move. And this is almost as the same as flanking behind, but you can do this in front too. So in Pesha, we don't want to shoot them now. I was lucky, no scan, and now I can kill them all from behind.
Oh yeah, oh yeah,
and
get on!
Keep holding the right side. I tried to flank more and go to spawn kill, but I get scanned, so I need to come back. And hold it like this. And now the lagger is gonna kill me. Ugh.
No, he didn't die. He's fucking low.
This is called unpredictable flanking. So we go straight in the middle. We want to do something that you cannot do without cloak. So you just can't run there. And now after the next guy is dead, we can choose to spawn kill them or get back and camp. And I choose to go back. But you need to be unpredictable when you cloak, so they don't know your moves. And same team on Tomsk here. So as you can see, enemies camping the point. Oh, I'm just camping here on the tower. What the fuck? Like always. Yep. And now I need to get away because they know I'm here. They are gonna hardscope me next time. So get the cloak. I get scanned. Some panic shooting. Cloak again. And now we want to get to a good spot. Here we sneak. And here we go. We cleared the point. And here we are going to cap Delta back on nukes. So clock on, pray for no scan, and they're not scanning. Then if somebody has the color camo, you always need to melee him, okay? And now I'm getting a good spot and not too aggressive. I'm not just pushing, I'll wait. I always have better spot than them and they need to push, so this is like defensive attacking, I should say. And we're done. And this is also defensive attacking, you should say. I'm camping in the old spawn because I hate my life, I hate this game, I hate this matchmaking, I'm lagging, all that shit. But as you can see, when we get a good chance, opportunity to get on the point. First we kill the blitz. And now, you can see there's a lot of enemies on the point, they're not focusing on you. Now it's your chance. So clock on. Okay, we kill him first. Okay, another try. And now instead of rushing straight in, we kill this guy. Then the noob is going to die. Wait for second noob to die. And always distract and kill the enemies after they kill your noob. And as you can see what the title said, change spots. So we're just flanking here now while we're capping the last point on Robitech. And now we kill an enemy. They know I'm here, I change the spot. I get scanned, they still know. But after we killed these two guys, last guy we killed like 50 seconds ago, he's all spawning now. So there's a lot of guys coming for me, so I need to do something fast. I was lucky I avoided the blackout. And now get the hell out of there, because they're coming back for you. And this is a perfect example for chasing spots. So now we kill this guy. Love it now, hello. And the sniper is hardscoping me, we can see, because he has the laser. And we chase the spot and kill him. And this one is a nice one. So first we camp here, like shit, as always.
I don't know what this shit is called.
But now, we can see there's another cloaker coming, so I cloak and stay. He's moving. I can see him going there, and I can kill him. And now we can see another cloak coming. Unfortunately, I missed him. So I just shoot, and now I was like the lucky one. And now I'm showing you that defensive gameplay is easier than attacking, so they need to push, not me. And now we use the cloak as advantage, and unfortunately there was a fourth guy who killed me. But there I waited, killed one. Get back, cloak, and repeat. And the next one is called small as possible. So what we want to do is cloak and be really small as possible, and then we can shoot when they don't see us. And it's harder against snipers, but usually it works too if you're prone down. And here's another one at Tomsk. He got laser detonator. We really go and glitch really small like this. And same on Attica against the LMG camper. We glitch. And boom. The last one is on nukes. We rush, kill one, jump down, kill the follower. And now there's people on point. We want to be as small as possible when we go in. So now, wait for the scan. Scan is over, so probably there's not next scans coming in a second. I'm proning down as small as possible. And now it's your chance. And when cloaking, you want to be sneaky. So now when we put the cloak and advance, we kill this guy and hide behind. So don't just run straight in. You need to think about it. And whoa! Okay, didn't see that one coming. And then there's the, of course, the tactic straight in, which usually people use and which usually gets you killed. But sometimes it works. But as you can see, when I went across the street, I was jumping and proning and all that stuff, so it's not straight movement when they enemies if there's sniper, for example, watching. So it's harder to see a cloak running there. And here's another one. Just trading. I got lucky no scans. Even with the shitgun PP2000, you can kill them all. But you really need luck and or wait until the enemy recons are dead or they have just used scan. And the last one, I tried to save the point, but I was too late. As you can see, over time, but they got it. So this kinda risky when I want to save the point, but I was like 1 second late. Just trade in and kill them all. And combat cloak is really, really useful when you use training tactic. Because when you shoot, there's 30% chance that your cloak doesn't get off. And the next one I'm calling looking for jackpot. What is basically that you don't shoot the first target. You want to get the really big kills. So it's kinda like getting the good spot before shooting, but this time there's a lot of enemies. Like this. And as you can see, the combat cloak really helped me out. And also the next clip. So we want to get the jackpot. Not shooting here the first guy. Looking. And now we get the jackpot. And as we all know, cloak is really good against bubbles and other devices too. So here's two examples. The first one is against bubble. We cloak. And jump trading and shoot. And the second one, no blitz, this is a really nice one. If you cannot kill the blitz, you need to pray that there's no scan. So here, I can see the blitz coming and more guys. I'll stand here, not in the middle, and not in the corners. And kill the guy behind.
No one still here.
So I avoided the blitz.
Where is he?
There we go. And here the same thing. We can see a blitz coming soon. So we take our cloak and get the fuck out of here. And not in the corner, not in the middle. And kill them. And this one is really playing for the team. So we are capping the point. And they have APS coming and big push, so we kill the APS and suicide. But that's worth it. And here, as you can see, APS coming. There's a smoke anyway, so he's panicking. APS is really weak if he doesn't have scan behind him. So this one is predict his moves. So when we are going to point, we're killing this guy. And now I'm alone at the point. I'm using cloak. I'm not moving, so I'll save it. I have a lot of time to stay here and see what's happening. Now there's enemy at the point. You can't see him anywhere, so he's trying to find you now. Hello. He was trying to go behind you. So you need to think what would you do if you were the enemy. And some people asked me how to do the melee kills, 50 melee kills with cloak. It's easy. Just do the same flanking but with melee. And it's also fun. It's really, really fun. And embarrassing to the opponents. And same thing here. As you can see soon. Here, I'm gonna make this guy panic. So I will cloak. He will hear the cloak. And he's going to be like, oh no, he's coming for me! And then we wait until the right moment and we melee him. Now he's like, oh fuck, I need to shoot him. The cloak. And boom. Goodbye. And this is called push and escape. And it's really common without cloak also on any class, on Nukes, like this. And we repeat the same thing. There's one guy at the point. Wait for scan. Kill him and jump back. Like this.
Up.
And push. And escape. The same thing. And now since this one guy doesn't want to die, I fell down and I need to kill him again. But we are pushing and then retreating. Fast.
Idiot.
And this is almost the same as change the spot, so when a lot of people or one hard scoping you, you take cloak. It helps if he has the laser designator like this. Change the spot and shoot. Surprise! And you need to be fast. And we know that both teams spawn at the same time. So here this noob just killed me. And we have to wait until they respawn. And now there's two dead. Three, four. And okay, we got the light tactical suit 6. So we are pretty fast. And if you have ultralight, it's really easy. So this works at least on sub end really well. And if you have noob LMG like this, you can do it. So cloak. And you're just in time to spawn kill them.
And here I want to show again
how you need to move small. So jump around and
crawl. Not running on the straight line, because then they will see you
easier. Oh, and I almost forgot to show you how you get easily, you can farm cloak kills. So
oh,
just camp and snipe, and when you are making your shot, press F fast. So here, enemy, press F, shoot! And as you can see, I got the cloak kill. 50 more points. And same thing. Just before you should press F. Now. Yes, cloak kill. There you go. Perkele.
Ah, he got me.
So, thank you guys for watching, I guess. And I forgot to upload one clip. That's really important, but that's not basically a cloak thing. That's also with all the classes. You need to smoke the bubble if it's coming, so... Oh, vittu. Ah, I don't care, it's over.
Up in the ass of Timo. That-